I'm standing here, but no one cares. I'm crying out, but no one's there.
Growing up in a Christian home, it's easy to just kind of adopt your parents' faith and adopt your parents' beliefs. And I think I did that for a while.
I went through a time of doubt probably after my sophomore year. It was a weird, awkward time for me because I was having these huge doubts, and it was after our first record was released. And so I kind of felt like the two-faced kind of guy, you know, on stage, you know, singing. I was doing interviews and magazine articles and covers, and I was like, okay, if I'm gonna be in this Christian music industry and people are gonna be looking up to me like this, that kind of scared me in a lot of ways. You know, that people were looking to me for like spiritual wisdom and spiritual advice, you know, when I felt like, you know, why is everybody doing this? You know, I'm just a guy that happens to play the guitar. And I think that was a little overwhelming for just that feeling of, I don't have all the answers. And is that okay to say, you know? And I didn't know if that was okay to say, because I felt this hidden pressure from different things to pretend like I, you know, had everything together. The world looks at Christianity and goes, okay, are these people for real? Like, what do they, I mean, are they real people? Because if they're real people, then I'm sure then they must struggle sometimes, you know? They must struggle with lust. They must struggle with depression or sadness or questions or doubt. And I would be cheating them and cheating the church if I pretended like I had things together.
Our ministry is through our music. You know, we don't use our music as a platform to preach and give altar calls. We definitely don't feel like we need to preach to anybody. Just feel like we need to be ourselves.
God's not afraid of our fears, our doubts, or our emotions. So that's one thing that's been really cool for me to slowly learn is I could just be myself with God, and that's all He really wants.
I love that scripture verse that, you know, and I pray that Christ will be more in your hearts as you trust in Him, that your roots grow deep in the soil of God's marvelous love, so you may see how wide, how high, how long, how deep His love is, really is for you. And I'm searching for that. I'm searching for the wideness and the fullness and the lengthiness of God's love in all its beauty. And then peace. I think peace is a beautiful thing.